Have you ever wondered how to get that dodge and burned look without spending all that time in Photoshop? Look, I know you have. I know you have because I have. We're both lazy. It's okay. We can admit it. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Lightroom and an editing technique they refer to as dark mode to go from this to this in absolutely no time. My name is Pi, and I'm one of the founders of Lynn and Jersa Photography and SLRLounge.com. We're teaming up with Adorama to bring you a new series of photography tutorials called Master Your Craft right here on Adorama TV. So let's dive in. What's up, my friends? My name is Pi. Welcome back to Adorama TV. So glad you're joining us. This would be a wonderful time to go ahead and grab the exercise files by following the description in the video below. The link in the description. You know what I'm saying. Let's go ahead and jump straight in. And what I want to do is in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys kind of our typical approach to editing. Then we're going to show you this new approach of what we refer to as dark mode editing. I'm going to help you guys to create your own preset so you guys can kind of utilize this setup with your own images, your own presets, everything. And I'm going to give you some demonstrations along the way as well as showing you how to shoot for dark mode. Yeah. This is gonna be a good one. You're gonna wanna bookmark this. Let's go ahead and dive straight in. So I have this image right here. This is of my buddy Dylan. And what we would typically do with an edit is we would raise exposure. We'd kind of look to pull down our highlights and we would pull down our whites. I'm gonna raise the shadows, maybe lower the black point, maybe add a little bit of contrast, you know, the huge. And then we'd go into like our color adjustments and everything. But that's the typical way we would do an edit, right? Raise exposure, balance everything out, kind of go for this, you know, preserving the highlights thing. What we're gonna do with dark mode is almost the exact opposite. So before I explain kind of how to shoot for it and everything else, I want you just to see what it does. So this is a raw file. This was shot on a 1DX3 and the subject is just in natural light against a darker background. And what I'm gonna do now, instead of raising the exposure, I'm actually going to lower it. In fact, I'm gonna take this down to -3, okay? This is a great starting point for a dark mode edit. What we're gonna do now is raise the black point all the way up to 100. And then we're gonna go to the highlights. And what I'm gonna do is start using highlights to lift the skin tones out. So instead of lowering highlights, we're actually raising the highlights and we're using the highlights to control the skin. We're gonna use the whites to actually control the white point on skin. So this becomes essentially that dodge that lifts out some of those nice little highlights over the nose and kind of the T-zone, you know, all the good stuff. Okay. And then if you want to raise the shadows a bit, you can raise the shadows a bit to get to a more kind of pleasing contrast. So this in a nutshell is dark mode. And from here, what I would do is kind of change the exposure just a little bit to get it exactly where I want. Now, let me show you. If I create a virtual copy of this by pressing Control apostrophe or Command apostrophe, and I reset this out, look at where we started and what a dark mode edit does. And I'm gonna go ahead and just add a little bit more exposure to this. So this dark mode edit almost acts as a dodge and burn without ever going into Photoshop. Okay, this is what's fun about this kind of technique. Okay, so now we've learned kind of the typical way that we might approach an image development is to raise exposure, balance out highlights and shadows. Now, dark mode is the exact opposite, lowering exposure, using the highlights over our subjects to control that brightness and doing that dodging and burning there. Now, let's go to step three. Well, how in the heck do we shoot for this dark mode look? Well, dark mode really requires an image to use or to be shot with chiaroscuro lighting, okay? This is an Italian term that references like basically just the difference in shading between light and dark. So you're basically using lights to highlight the subjects. And this is a painterly effect that was used by Rembrandt and all sorts of classic artists that would basically paint bright subjects over darker backgrounds. So that's really all we need, is we need skin tones to be brighter than our backgrounds. So when you look at this, this was shot in natural light. And when you see the behind the scenes video, we're literally standing on a sidewalk and I've just placed my subject kind of into the bushes. I mean, I love doing that. I'm literally walking around and when I see a bush, I'm like, you know what? Just get in the bush. You know what I mean? Like just get in the bush. It's gonna look good. So, you know, don't do what I just said right now at all. But anyway, she's being lit just with that natural light and then background is naturally darker than she is, which makes it perfect. But This is a natural light setup. You can do this in any scene or situation. Now, this image is not gonna work with dark mode because if I reset this out and I start using, I drop my exposure and I start using highlights to control my subject's skin tone, his skin wasn't in the highlights. The scene itself is in the highlights. So we have no highlights on the skin, which means that this has to be processed as an HDR image. So let's go to another scene. This is another scene. I'm gonna make sure this is fully reset out by pressing Control Shift R. And all that's happening in the scene is we're using the windows to control the highlights, right? So I've just used the curtains to kind of close them down a little bit, placed her in the spot where that window light's coming in and kept the background a bit dark. What is the exposure? It's 1/200 of a second, 1.8, ISO 800. Background is left nice and dark and we just kind of control the light in that way. So this works perfectly because all I gotta do is lower the exposure, raise my black point, and start playing with my highlights to lift her out. And you can see that we now darken what's already kind of dark in the image or darker than our subjects, and we lift out our subject using this technique. I'm just gonna make this kind of quick and dirty, okay? So same thing on this image. This is shot in the studio. This go around, we're using a strobe and we're lighting her up with a nice soft light and just making sure that once again, the background is darker than the highlights on our skin. And it works perfectly. In fact, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna encourage you. So let's go back to this image right here. And I'm actually gonna click the dark mode preset. So inside of Visual Flow Tools, so if you use Visual Flow Development Tools, you already have dark mode along with all of our retouching tools, along with the actual presets. But if you don't have them, it's totally okay. If you guys don't wanna buy it, I'm gonna show you how to get it right here. So this is the baseline default setting that we use for dark mode, and we're gonna create the preset together. So you're gonna dial in -3, +73 for highlights, +53 for shadows, zeroed out for white balance, or sorry, the whites, and then blacks are at 100. Now, once you go up to the plus and you're gonna go create new preset, click check none, select your basic tone options only, as well as process version, give it a name, save it out as dark mode. Now, we're choosing this because this goes into step 4. I wanna show you how you can use dark mode in conjunction with the presets that you already have, or if you have Visual Flow with these presets. But it's really cool because you can stack this effect over one of those settings. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's create that out. I'm gonna press cancel because we already have it, okay? So what I'm gonna do is just kind of get this image back to where I like it by kind of just adjusting up, and we'll kind of bring the exposure up a little bit. And right about here is pretty nice, where we have this nice look. I'm gonna create a virtual copy here because now what I'm gonna do is actually reset this out. And I want you just to choose your favorite preset. You could choose a preset that you've created for yourself, one of your favorite ones from a pack, a Visual Flow one. You could even just dial in the color settings that you'd like to have. Just dial in those settings now. What I'm gonna do is select from the Visual Flow Modern Pack, which kind of creates this nice warmth and bright look to an image. I'm gonna select Soft Light, okay? Then from there, select that dark mode preset that you just made, okay? It's gonna invert the colors. And now from this place, we're gonna make our subtle tweaks and adjustments. I'm gonna add to my highlights. And look at this, what we've just done now is we've created a dark mode look with an existing color setup. So if I compare this to that previous image, you'll see that all of our color tones from the soft light preset, from that modern soft light preset, are now applied with this dark mode look. And what I would do now, I'm gonna drop in a radial burn. All this does is if you press Shift M, this is dropping in a radial burn at -0.5 right over my subject's skin in the middle. And here's what I would do. You can create that radial burn on your own. These are things that I'm always doing. I'm dropping in these radial burns in the center of my image, right? So rather than doing it manually each time, drop it in to whatever strength that you like, go up here and save this out as a preset only using the radial filters. Now you can add a radial burn anywhere and just simply move it around as opposed to creating it manually each time. Now, this is what's fun about this is we've literally done nothing. This takes seconds to do. And if you wanna take this into Photoshop and go at this point and do additional dodging and burning and kind of bring the eyes out and do whatever you want, you're totally can do that. But most of the work has now been done for you. And if you compare the before and the after, it's pretty night and day, like the way that she pops out from the background now compared to the original file. Now, if you made it this far, first, I want you to comment below and be like, dude, I made it to the hair technique and it was awesome because a lot of you are gonna bail before that. But here we go. A lot of retouch can be done inside of Lightroom. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to my adjustment brushes. We've built out a full retouching kit inside of Visual Flow Development Tools. So this is literally a workflow-based retouching kit that does everything. Okay, so all you do is you literally select what you want. And right now what I want is to enhance hair detail. So what you're gonna do is pause the video and dial in all of these settings, because now you have a hair enhancement brush preset already for you. It's raising exposure, it's boosting contrast, it's lifting highlights significantly, it's going to increase shadows, drop the whites a little bit, raise the, or drop the blacks just a little bit, add texture, and the overall look and effect, when I paint this over hair, you're gonna see it just kind of add gloss to hair, okay? Here's the next fun part about this. If you want to strengthen it, hold down Alt or Option and just click and drag to the right to strengthen the effect. Now I can nicely kind of strengthen and enhance the hair. I'm gonna do that on the opposite side as well, just to get a little bit of extra pop from this. And if you watched this little tip on hair, I want you guys to comment because I think it's fun. I really want to be the Bob Ross of photography tutorials. I'm gonna paint happy clouds in every photo, but except instead of happy clouds, I'm gonna do hair. Hair is gonna be my happy clouds. I love that man. I spent a lot of my childhood watching. Okay, so a lot of things we can do directly from Lightroom, okay? I might do one other thing since you're here and, you know, just because we can. Let's do a little bit of eye enhancement. So press new. I'm gonna go and we're gonna drop into this again and we're gonna go down to eyes, enhanced detail. We can also do whiten, but I'd start with enhanced detail. Dial this in, pause the video, save it out as a new preset. Again, you save brush presets by dropping down here. Once you have the settings dialed in, you drop down here and say save current settings, a new preset. Save it. This is gold. You're getting three presets. Mikey, Carlo, it's crazy. We're giving them free presets. All right, it's cool. You guys don't have to say anything. Like, they're in the background, but just make me feel like a crazy person. That's fine. So what I'm gonna do is paint this over the eyes, and what this does is it kind of enhances detail and just adds a little bit of sharpness to it. And then I'm gonna go new, and we're gonna go ahead and add a whiten. Once again, dial this in, pause, dial in all these settings, and we're gonna just paint this in right over kind of the base whites of the eyes. Now, I like to feather this off, so holding down Alt or Option, I'll kind of feather this off in the shape of the shadows that are already landing on the eyes, okay? So that way it kind of looks a little bit more natural. So where the shadows would be in kind of this dark area of the iris, I'm gonna do that. And just for shizzes and giggles, let's do one more. Go new and go intensify iris. Pause the video, dial this in. Yeah, that's now four presets. Okay, I'm gonna paint this right over the iris. And what this is gonna do is just lift out some of the color tone in the eyes. I want it to be very subtle. And the way that you guys can check, once you've done all this stuff, the way that you check to make sure it's subtle and not noticeable is you zoom back out. In fact, you can go back to grid view. Look at it from grid view with a large thumbnail. And look at it and say, do the eyes pop out in an unnatural sort of way? If the eyes look kind of normal, you're good. If the eyes look like they're glowing, like an alien that has glowing eyes, you've gone a little too far. But with just that, it's so much fun, because look at this. We've gone from this image, this before image, to this final, and we never even had to touch Photoshop to get there. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Be sure to subscribe to the Adorama TV channel, like the video, let me know what you thought about it, what you guys would like to see next. I get a lot of ideas from all of your guys' comments, so please let me know, and I'm happy to create tons more tutorials for y'all. In the meanwhile, if you guys want to check out more about Visual Flow presets, be sure to go to vfpresets.com, and for more of the best A to Z education for photographers, portrait photographers, those that want to start businesses, go to srloungeworkshops.com as well. You guys can follow me at PyJirsa, and in the meanwhile, I'm going to see you all in the next video. Peace.